This elderly lady has come to us with a swelling in the right parotid region of 3 years duration, which is very slowly progressing and it is painless. There are no other swellings in the neck, no symptoms suggestive of facial nerve palsy. On inspection, as you can see, there is a single swelling of 4 into 3 cm size. Most important here is the position. It is in front, below and behind the ear lobule, a typical site for the parotid gland swelling. A larger swelling will lift the ear lobule. It is oval in shape in the parotid region, extending from the mastoid process to 1 cm above the angle of the mandible. Surface appears nodular. Borders are ill-defined. Skin over the swelling appears normal. Retromandibular space is obliterated. On palpation, there is no local rise of temperature, no tenderness. Confirm the inspectory findings. Then the surface is nodular. A firm nodule here and the rest of the gland is hard. It is mobile. After contracting the masseter, its mobility is not restricted, indicating that it is neither infiltrated nor arising from the masseter. So plane is superficial to the masseter. Please note the obliteration of the retromandibular hollow. It is a sign of parotid swelling. The mobility of the parotid is restricted up to the zygomatic arch, as the parotid fascia enclosing the gland is attached to it like this. This will help to differentiate parotid swelling from other preauricular subcutaneous swellings. This is called as curtain sign. Examine the region between the third molar and the tonsil for the deep lobe of the parotid. It can be palpated by bimanual examination. Here there is no enlargement of the deep lobe. Features of malignancy in a parotid swelling include facial nerve involvement, fixity to the skin or masseter, enlarged cervical and restricted jaw movements. Examine the facial nerve by asking the patient to clench the teeth and see for deviation of the angle of the mouth. Ask the patient to puff out the cheeks. The paralyzed side bellows more than the normal side. Ask the patient to close the eyes. The affected side will not close or it will be weak. Here there is no deviation of the angle of the mouth. Bilateral symmetrical wrinkling of the forehead is seen. Equal tension on both cheeks on puffing out. Bilateral closure of the eyelids is normal, so there is no involvement of facial nerve.